great to be here. So thank you, Grace, and also Michelle, Grace's co-chair, the other co-chair, the TYPC, for inviting me. Jamie, do you want to come up?
Watch first.
It's time.
Watch first.
I'm here too, but we're all...
I'm going to stick my ass up there.
So I'm not sure if we need to do introductions, if we all kind of had a chance to say a few words, but when I was talking about this panel with Michelle and Grace, the main question that we were talking about is, you know, how do we understand Google's power in the food system? And then I guess conversely, you know, how do we take the power in the food system and understand the most effective ways to do that? So I think everybody here brings a different background and perspective on that. Rod is going to go first, and as he mentioned, he was the first coordinator of the Toronto Food Policy Council when it was started in 1990. And after that, did a lot of really interesting consulting work in the world of local sustainable food, including a lot of work with the organic sector and work with Local Food Plus in establishing the standards that they use, their certification standards. And then in the past 5 years or so, has taken a position with York University, if any of you know him, through his work there on food policy and, of course, teaching. Jamie will go next, and Jamie's the executive director of the Holland Marsh Growers Association. So I got to know Jamie through my work at Sustain Ontario, where very quickly I realized he really understands the world of food and farming politics intimately. Before that, he was a journalist, actually, with The Grower, which is a national fruit and vegetable magazine publication in Canada. And he's always a great guy to have on the panel. Is somebody I've met more recently, and Carly's a food lawyer, like she mentioned in her intro, and has been working in different areas around social justice and law over the past years. Most recently, she's begun to work a lot with street food vendors and food truck vendors here in Toronto. She was one of the leads with Toronto Underground Market, which is hot new thing in food in Toronto, and is helping a lot of these food entrepreneurs navigate the system, the really complex system of bylaws, zoning, rules and regulations that they have to kind of surf in order to realize their idea. So with that, I think, Rod, what our idea is that each of the panelists will talk for 10 minutes. I think immediately following each person, we'll take a couple of questions just as kind of points of clarification, sort of shorter conversations. Leave your more kind of integrative questions for the end, and we'll have, we have a great group, we have lots of time, we can have a really good discussion. And then I think we'll close by just kind of coming back and asking